So in Mahabharata, before the Kurukshetra war, Arjuna was given a choice. A choice where he could use Krishna's 10,000 warriors to fight for the Pandavas or Krishna himself alone. Arjuna chose Krishna. Do you know why? It's because of his immense faith and unbreakable trust he had on Krishna. Trust is like a glue which binds all relationships together. Between that of parent, child, the husband, wife, people, society, and that of the leader and the led, it's a fundamental foundation of all relationship. In today's world, are we safe to send our children to school without fear? In family, do spouses truly believe one another? Is there a society without violence? Think about it. Trust begins with self. It's a crux of everything. A drop in the center can cause a ripple effect on relationship, organization, market, and society. In office, when the boss gives a complex job, you get to hear, "Oh, shh, man, this time terrorist, he doesn't want me to sleep in peace." People do not believe themselves. Anything is possible. We need to pull our weights up. Nobody is going to push us up. In relationship, having mutual trust and loving unconditionally without any ulterior motive is very, very important. Trust takes years to build, seconds to break, and forever to repair. Understanding partner's preference, giving space, fostering kindness are some of the ways to build mutual trust. As parents, it's our utmost responsibility to teach our children trust, the importance of trust, respect, and discipline. We may not be able to change the older generation, but we can definitely mold the newer generation. In organization, an employee who feels himself trusted will work very hard. I asked a colleague of mine, "Shilpa, how long will you take to complete this job?" She said, today. Today means 2 days for her. So the first step in any organization or build trust in an organization is to set the expectations right, as well as to meet the deadlines. Trust is like a lubrication which makes organizations to work together. What else can we do to improve the trust in an organization? Remember 4 A's. Accept more responsibilities. Acknowledge others' work. Admit your failures and advance your expertise. We engineers might not believe in philosophy or mythology. So let's look at trust with engineering glasses. Trust can be mathematically expressed as trust is equal to competency into integrity by risk. What I mean by competency is my expertise or my ability. Integrity is my honesty level, and risk is the risk associated with the task. Suppose I ask Syed, "Hey Syed, I left my purse at my block. Can you lend me 100 rupees? Will you give me or not?" 99% he will give me. But what if I ask him 100,000 rupees? He will first evaluate my competency to repay, my integrity or my honesty level, and the risk associated with not getting the money back. All you might not know is I might go from club to club borrowing money. Trust is bidirectional. I need to trust others and others need to trust me. But too much of trust or blind trust is also bad. If the wife tells the husband, "Your mother is sitting in front of the TV whole day and I'm the one sweating in the kitchen," and if he truly believes her, then there starts the argument, or it could be the vice versa. It should be a balanced equation. Trust is like a blood pressure, vital for health, but if abused, can cause ill health. Trust is not a one-time job. It has to be a continuum from birth to death. So fellow Toastmasters and friends, believe in yourself, respect relationship, and be trustworthy to the organization. If you can follow all these things successfully and continuously, then markets of trust and social trust will automatically improve. Trust in yourself, You know more than what you think you do, and you might not be able to trust the person you love, but you can always love the person you trust. Over to you.